Good morning.
Good morning.
To God be the glory for all the marvelous things He is and will and has done. Amen. This is Palm Sunday, the Sunday before Easter, Resurrection Sunday, when Jesus came in triumphantly into Jerusalem and they were singing, Hosanna, Hosanna, blessed be the King. Amen. As we gather together on this day, we do as our custom. We begin by affirming our faith. We remember and we remind ourselves in our whole spirit of who we are and what God has done and is doing in our lives. Amen. So we invite us to stand together and to affirm our faith. You can follow along with us on the screen, or if not, you'll find them with handouts in your back seats. Back of the pews. Amen. When I doubt my worth, I know that. When I fall behind, I know that. When I'm rejected by people, I know that. When I feel defeated and attacked, I know that. When I'm discouraged in my faith, I know that. When I'm told that I hate you, I know that. When I'm cursed by others, I know that. To God be the glory. You may be seated. Let's pray together. Father, we thank you so much for your goodness, your grace, your abundance of mercy, how we give you praise and adoration. God, this is the day you have made, and we're called to rejoice and to be glad in it. God, we assemble ourselves once more again. God, just to come to worship you, to serve you, to honor you in all that we do. God, may all that we do in word and deed be done and pleasing in your sight, oh God. God, I heard the psalmist says, may the words of our mouths and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable unto you, oh God. May our worship, may our service, may our just camaraderie and fellowship be honoring and pleasing unto you, dear Heavenly Father. We ask and pray in Jesus' name that your Holy Spirit would just move in our midst on this day, God. Move in such a way, oh God, that we will know that we have been in your presence, oh God. Move in such a way, oh God, that that aching bodies would be healed and comforted, that weary souls will find stability and rest, oh God, that worried minds, oh God, would have a peace that surpassed understanding, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, that grieving hearts would be comforted and bereaved hearts would be comforted. God, we honor you right now and give you praise and thanks, oh God. And God, when we come, God, recognizing that we're but filthy rags. Our best righteousness is but filthy rags before you, God. But we humbly offer ourselves to you this day, Heavenly Father, because, God, we have no other place to go, God. If we flee to the mountains, you're there. If we go down to the depths of the oceans, God, you're there. You're everywhere at the same time. And so we can't run from you, so we're going to run to you, God. We can't outrun you, God, because you're every place. We're going to bump into you in our misery. We're going to bump into you in our joy. We're going to bump into you in our sorrow. So Thank you for being every place at the same time and rocking us in the cradle of your arms. Thank you, God, for who you are and what you are in Allah. God, how we honor you today. So, Lord, as we offer ourselves, as we offer this worship, this praise, this adoration, this proclamation soon, oh God, may it be pleasing and honoring unto you. So, God, we have members among us, oh God, who are sick and afflicted right now. God, our hearts are bleeding, our hearts are aching, God, but we know that you are a healer, God. God, I heard about the centurion soldier who said, don't have to come to my house, just say the word, God. God, the little girl that died, Heavenly Father, we know that you just said, God, she's just asleep. You woke her up, God. And Lazarus, 4 long days in the grave, God, you're an all-powerful God. So if you can heal a centurion from miles away, you sure enough can go to Houston and to New York. You can go down to Gonzales and to Goliath. God, you can move in a miraculous way. So touch, heal right now, Heavenly Father. God, I heard someone says, while on others thou art calling, God, don't pass us by, God. Don't pass, God. I'm not trying to be selfish, God, but as you're going, God, just stop by my house. As you're going through and fro this earth, oh God, stop by our house, oh God, and just touch and minister and move in a special way. God, we honor you and we invite you, oh God, to please, oh God, have your way. We offer ourselves to you, oh God, for your glory, your honor, God. God, may all that we do be pleasing in your sight. And we ask it all in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Y'all, we still have time where we fellowship. So invite us to stand up, move around, shake hands, meet and greet someone that you have not seen, and share the peace. Just tell them, peace be with you. Amen. Give them some peace. Amen. I am going to stay on the battlefield.
I'm going to stay on the battlefield.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to treat everybody right, as that's hard right. as it may get sometimes.
That's right.
I just think they may be struggling to treat me right, too, you know, because nobody's perfect. I can't put it all on them.
Amen.
Sometimes it's me.
All right.
Amen. Amen. That's why we need God. That's why we need Jesus.
Right.
Amen. We are in the Lenten season right now. And Easter is next Sunday.
Yes, it is.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, it is.
And then we just celebrate Jesus.
That's right.
I just love calling the name. Remember, Antoine said there's power in his prayer.
Uh-huh.
In the name of Jesus. I said, look at God. Amen. He was talking about you can't move without bumping into him. You know, I remember when I used to ride those bumper cars, I would be so scared to get on those bumper cars. But then once you got in it, and you just bumping around, hitting people, hitting different things, hitting the wall. It was so much fun to be in the bumper car.
Right.
And we survived them.
That's right.
Life may throw us around, but we are surviving with God.
That's right. Amen.
I'm just a little excited. Good things have been happening this week. I'm just excited.
Come on.
Amen. All right, Sister Patsy.
Oh my,
la 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 la.
Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us.
Lord, I lift
your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way from the earth to the cross. My debt to pay from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. Lord, I lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. Savior to the cross. My death came from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross. My death came from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross. My death came from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross. My death is paid, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross. My death is paid, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift your name on high. 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 Lord, I lift your name on high.
Amen. Got to give him praise.
Amen.
What he did for us, he most definitely deserves praise.
That's right.
Amen. I just got to share a little testimony. I know one day someone's going to throw a shoe at me, and I'm going to take it as a compliment. The church has been praying for my son, Ryan, and I thank you guys. I thank my church family for the prayers. It was scary. It was definitely scary. And we have a long ways to go, but we're moving up.
Right.
We're moving up, and doors are opening. We're finding doctors down here, right. And things are just because of God. I'm just going to say it that way.
Yes. Amen.
And in the middle of this storm that we are going through, and storms don't last always, I'm just saying. But in the middle of this storm, Ryan got a call. He interviewed at Goliath High School Thursday to be a math teacher. So you guys keep praying for my baby.
Good.
He got definitely the math side, I didn't. But I don't mess with my money. That's what I'm because I can figure that out. And then Friday, he got a call from Nordheim ISD. Right. Y'all better be praising with me. Woo. We have been struggling. And thank God for family and church family. Thank God for cards that people are sending us. And you open the card and money fall out. I'm like, it's a miracle. I opened the bill, but no money came out. I'm just like, okay. But I am, there's hope.
That's right.
And in the midst of that storm,
amen,
the power of Jesus prevails every
single
time.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. So keep praying that he does well on Monday. He will, because God's already told us to go to the interview. And I said us, but I'm probably going to be sitting in the car. Thank you. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus.
To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus.
To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
There's an army rising up. There's an army rising up. There's an army rising up. To break every chain, break every chain. Break every chain, to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. There's an army rising up. There's an army rising up. There's an army rising up. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Can you hear that army? Can you hear the chains break?
Yeah.
Woo. I got a testimony. You better shake, clap those hands. Praise God. British back there waving her hand. Amen.
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 because of who you are, I give you glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are, Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are, because of who you are, I give you glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are, Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are, Jehovah Jireh, my provider, Jehovah Nissi, Lord, you reign in victory, Jehovah Shiloh. My Prince of Peace, and I worship you because of who you are. Because of who you are, I give you glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are, Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are, Jehovah Jireh, my provider, Jehovah Nissi, Lord, you reign in victory, Jehovah Jireh, my Prince of Peace, and I worship you because of who you are.
Amen. worship you because of who you are.
God, we worship you because of who you are. The great I am. The true and living God. We thank you for being healer and comforter. We thank you for being omnipresent, omniscient, and omnipotent. And I ask and pray even now that the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob would just come and rest within my heart and empower me to do that which you've called me to do at this very moment. God, help me to proclaim your truths, oh God, in such a way that you are recognized and glorified, but those of us assembled are edified, that we might, Lord, be used for you, for your glory. I ask that you would hide me so deep in the shadow of your cross that I'm not seen, but you and you alone. And when it's all said and done, my desire is but to hear you say, well done. To that end, we give you praise and thanks. In Jesus' name, amen. This morning, I want to give our attention to Luke's gospel, Luke chapter number 19. If you would stand with us for the reading of God's word. We stand for the reading of God's word in reverence to his word. And so we respect God's word. We stand before his word as we read and hear it in this public setting. Luke chapter number 19. I want to begin reading in verse number 28. Luke 19 and beginning in verse number 28. It says, after he had said these things, he was going on ahead to Jerusalem. When he approached Bethphage and Bethany near the mount that is called Olivet, he sent two of his disciples, saying, go into the village ahead of you. There, as you enter, you will find a colt, a donkey tied on which no one yet has ever sat. Untie it and bring it here. If anyone asks you, why are you untying it? You shall say, the Lord has need of it. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I want to talk about, can the Lord use you? Last weekend, here in Goliad, it was the county fair and parade and festivities and carnival and rodeo and all that kind of thing. And in a parade, you notice that there are usually vehicles that are used in the parade, and dignitaries and honorees are often driven around in these vehicles, and those vehicles that they're driven around in are usually typically borrowed from someone. They're typically borrowed from a car dealership. And you notice that most of the time in the parade, the name of the honoree or the dignitary is plastered on the side of the vehicle. And rarely do you see, but on occasion you might see, let me say this, who was gracious enough to allow someone to use their vehicle. In this last year's parade, this year's parade in particular, you saw, and they had people's names and so forth and so on. And they had, like, for instance, Grand Marshal Sheila Edwards, was plastered on both sides of the vehicle. That's Sheila Edwards. We know Sheila Edwards. And other people had, and when the mayor is riding, they'll put the mayor's name, whether they are running for office or not, the name is there. And so you don't see or hear a lot about who gave, but when you do, you'll see something in kind of smaller print and say something like courtesy of so-and-so. In some communities, it's up to the honorees or the dignitaries to secure their vehicle to ride in. And other times, the parade organizers will go and solicit someone to use their vehicles for the parade. In our text today, we have Jesus getting ready to have a parade. And he tells his disciples, I need you to go and get me a ride. I need you to go inside the city and go and find, when you enter the city, you will find a colt, a donkey there that is tied up that no one has ever sat on. I need you to bring him to me. Bring it to me. And if anyone asks you, why are you untying it? Say, the master needs it. The rest of the verses that we did not read in that chapter says that they took the coat, they found the coat, as Jesus has said, and they had a dialogue with the owners of the donkey, and they just repeated that statement, why are you doing it? And Jesus, they answered, because they have need of it. We often talk about this or use this passage during Palm Sunday to celebrate the parade, to celebrate the honoree, and rightfully so. But I think sometimes we overlook the donkey in the story. How many of you are Shrek fans? How many of you like donkey? Shrek has a name. Shrek is an ogre. He has a name. His wife is an ogre. She's got a name. Donkey is just... Now, everybody got Shrek shirts, got Shrek, Fiona, and all that kind of stuff. But all you know is donkey. And it's okay if folk don't know your name as long as you're in the movie. We get too caught up. They didn't put my name. It's just donkey. And so Jesus says, go and get this donkey. And because we have need of him, it's a young donkey. And watch this. This donkey is used for God's mission and his glory. And you would think that we would at least give some attention to the donkey. Now somebody gonna say, well, Reverend, you ought to just preach about Jesus. I'm about to, but you can't miss the details of the text. God is an economist of words. In other words, everything he puts in there is for a reason. There are not too many words and not too less words. If God put it in, if he said it, he meant it. God doesn't need to use a lot of verbose, be verbose and use a lot of words and stuff like that. Whatever he got to say, he say to the point, and if he said it, he meant what he said. And so he wanted us to see that he has used a donkey. He has called a donkey into service for him. Here's my question to you. Are you willing to be used for God's mission and his glory? Can God come and solicit you? Well, someone will ask the question, well, what's the criteria? I'm glad you asked. Let's look at the donkey, if you will. God uses those, watch this, those who may be or who are the least among us. The donkey. He did not say, go and untie a horse. Because it would figure to me that if royalty is coming inside of the city, then he would want some kind of regal animal. He would want some kind of regal beast to ride upon. You know, when you walk into the stadium and you're riding on that nice big stallion and you high up on that. No, he says, go get a donkey. Now, some of us would say a jackass. God can use a jackass. That's his name. Okay, so somebody said, Reverend Cuss. He didn't cuss. He didn't curse. Jack is what the donkey is known as. Jenny is what a female donkey. Am I in the country? So when they say jackass, that just means it's a male donkey. But whether you a Jack or a Jenny, God can use you. But watch this. It's unlikely, or God can use the unlikely for his service. Why would God go and get a donkey? I mean, of all the other animals that you could have come up, you're supposed to be the King of Kings. You say you're the Lord of Lords. You're the Messiah. You come from, and you're riding here on a donkey? And Jesus says, I want to show somebody that I can use a donkey for my glory. Why? Because the donkey is allowing me to use him. He gets a donkey, but not just any donkey. He gets, watch this, y'all. He gets a young donkey who's never been ridden on before, which means the donkey is inexperienced. Let me help somebody real quick. Well, Reverend, I ain't been to seminary. That's okay. I've been. It's my job to help you understand what seminary is. Everybody have to go to seminary. That's why I'm gone, so I can come back and teach you what you should know about how to do and help walk you along. So don't tell me you're inexperienced. Inexperience has nothing to do with it, because if I recall the first job you got, you ain't had no experience on that job, but you took the pay cut. You took them people checking till you can figure out how to do it, huh? I know somebody want to shout amen, but you don't want to be too loud. I didn't know how to do this, Reb, but I've been there 25 years. I bet you have been. But God can come in and say, listen, I've got a donkey. Watch this. He's inexperienced. And God likes that, because when folks who recognize that they are inexperienced, and they don't have a lot to offer, they're much more humble. It's folk who think they know it all that God have a hard time using. I know all the Bible. No, you don't know all the Bible. You barely can spell it if I give you all of the consonants. It's just I and E that's definite. If what you need to know is, are you willing in your inexperience? Has God ever used you before in something? Said, I don't know how to witness God. He said, I'm glad you don't, because then you try to mess it up. Just tell somebody your story. I once was lost, but now I'm blind. I once was blind, but now I see. I once was lost, but now I'm found. That's, you ain't got to know all these other things. Just tell them what you do know. God can use the least among them. And watch this, the donkey was just a common animal. He was a common beast of burden. It was used. Mary rode in on a donkey when she came in from into Bethlehem. And so Jesus figured out he came in riding on a donkey. He can leave out on a, somebody gonna miss that right quick. I've been riding on a donkey since my mother's womb. My mother walked into a place on a donkey. She rode into a place on a donkey. The donkey was just a common thing. And God, watch this, it's a common beast of burden. It had no special pedigree, but God says, that's all I need. I can use the common. I can use the ordinary folk. You don't have to come from wealth and riches. You don't have to come from some high society, folks. You can just be born on the backside of Goliath. You can be born in the back of the field. You can be born in some little shanty house. You can come from the boroughs. I'm just a boy from the west side of New Iberia. Folk didn't think I was going to make it, but look at me now. God can use the common and elevate them. A couple was out in town one day. They was having dinner one evening, and they was enjoying their dinner. They was eating their meal, and right in the middle of the meal, they received the phone call. The husband received the phone call. from their monitoring system, the loan monitoring system. And it says, sir, this is so-and-so from the monitoring system. It says, we are detecting an alarm at your home. It seems as though the back door is open or broken into. What would you like us to do? Would you like us to send the police? And the gentleman said, yes, please send the police. He and his wife finished up. They stopped their meal, paid their tab, and they drove out. By the time they get there, the police has already gotten there. Police is looking around the house. The police doesn't go in the house because they don't have permission. They go into the house and they see the rooms and they're tossed up and down in shambles and ransacked. And the police said to the lady, and the man says, do you see any things that they could have stolen or anything valuable? And the lady says, she looked around and says, well, hold on, follow me. And they went into her bedroom and it said, and the bedroom was tossed in the dresser where her jewelry was tossed and her makeup and all that was tossed around. And then she went and she found, and she said, everything was tossed around except that one little mason jar with some tape on it. But it was just left all alone. The woman went to the mason jar, picked up the mason jar, she opened it up, and she poured everything out of it. And she said, the police, no, they didn't steal nothing but my costume jewelry that I put on the dresser. She said, I put the good stuff in the mason jar. He said, why would you put the good stuff in the mason jar? Because folks don't figure anything good is in some little mason jar. Can I help somebody right quick? Paul said this in 2 Corinthians. He says, for we have these treasures in earthen vessels that the all-surpassing power of God might be seen and not be of us. God, y'all, we just some common, ordinary country folk that God decided he was going to put some stuff inside of us, and folk don't want to boo boo with us because they don't think we ain't got much. But let me tell you something, honey. God can put some rich stuff in an old common boy, an old country boy, old country girl, and folks get my, who is that? From Goliath. Who is that from Victoria? That's somebody who's got something on the inside of them that God is willing. He can use the least. But then those who are lent by him. The text says in verse 31 and in 33, he says, if anyone asks you, why are you untying it? You shall say, the Lord has need of it. Verse 33 says, and as they were untying it, its owners said to them, why are you untying it? They said, the Lord has need of them. They said, let me give you a little quick Greek lesson right quickly. So that's why you ain't got to go to seminary. I can help you with these words. Watch this. This word that we translate in the English language as owners, it's the word kairos. And what kairos really means is Lord. It's the same thing as Jesus, Lord. Here's the difference between this kairos and when we say Jesus kairos. What it means is that when we says owners and lords, it's lowercase L. Somebody going to shout already. When we refer to Jesus, it's uppercase L. Watch this. He says that the uppercase L acts the lowercase L. Can I use what you got? Come on, don't help me up in here. He says, it's the same name, but it depends on who you tag it to. So Jesus says, now, he says, the big L asks the little L, can I use what you got? And the little L said, Lord, everything I have belongs to you. Whenever you let the big L be your big L, then your little L understand. And every time the little L see the big L, the little L bow down and say, whatever you want, you can take it. Can I help somebody? Because I'm in a hurry right now. And I'm about to preach myself happy. When he got so happy, he says, I'm going to surrender everything. Who needs this? He didn't have to say Jesus. He just said, the Lord. See, the issue is this. We want Jesus to be our Savior. But we don't want him to be our Lord. We say stuff like, he's my Savior. First giving honor to God. Who's the head? No, he's lying. Because if he's the head of your life, the head tells the body what to do. The neck does not have a brain. The arms does not have a brain. Everything that the body does in response to the head. And so if your brain dead, it cannot send a signal to the body.
So you declared brain dead, you can't move. You might say, well, they were jumping. Well, that's just some nerve, because every now and then you jump and you don't know why you're jumping. But the text says, watch this. He says, if they ask you, tell them the Lord needs it. And the man said, oh, the Lord, take it. I'm going to give it all. Watch this. When we give and we are lent of God, we say to God, I yield everything to you. God, my skills, you get it. Lord, my talent, you get it. Lord, my money, you take it. Lord, my time, you use it. Lord, my possessions, you have it. When you've been lent to God, you tell, watch this, and when you lent, you turn it over and let the lender do what he want to it. You know, I travel often, and so when I get into other cities, I rent a car. They usually call it a loaner car. And because I drive it, I got some restrictions. I can't be crazy in it, but they can't tell me where to go. They can't have me. You want to use the toll tag? I said no. You want to use no? Whatever. You want to do this? No. But they can't tell me what, why. Because once they give it to me, if I want to ride it in the desert, I ride it in the desert. If I want to go inside the city, watch this. They never track me, nor does the car tell me I'm in the wrong spot. When I turn it back in, they didn't ask me what happened, because they let me use it for my service. And all I'm trying to tell somebody is, when you allow God to use you, you can't tell him what you will and will not do. God, I ain't going to church. That ain't your job. I ain't going to church either. I'm going to worship. That's the problem. Too many of us trying to come to church. You are the church. And the reason why we don't worship and we get all thrown up and cut up is because we came for the wrong reason. We came for church and not for worship. You can't come for worship and be reckless. Watch this. And when I stand up to sing, I sing because of him. When I sing up, then to praise, I praise for him. And to preach and to pray. Watch this. I give myself away. It is easy for you to give your stuff to God when you've given yourself to God. Folks, some folks find it hard to give themselves and their stuff to God because they've not given themselves to God. And until you can give yourself first, then God can take everything else you got. There was a Methodist layman by the name of J.W. Deventer back in the late 1900s. He was a very faithful layman, and he was a skilled artist. He went to school for art and all those things like that. And he always wrestled with call in his life. And Deventer said he came to a critical point, Bert, in his life one day, and he just knew that God wanted something different in him. And Deventer said, I just said, you know what, Lord, I'm tired of fighting, I'm tired of struggling, I'm tired of boxing with you, because you can't box with God because your arm's too short. I decided I'm going to just give up. He says, inside of me, I just said, I'm going to surrender all to him. And then he said, "Is when I made that statement, then I realized his words were this: God had hidden a song in my heart and touched a tender chord that caused me to sing, I surrender all. All to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust him in his presence daily live. I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior. God had that song inside of him, but it couldn't come out of him until he surrendered all he had in him. And we still sing that song, whether you're Methodist, Baptist, Catholic, Presbyterian, everybody have to make a statement, I surrender all. Well, not only that, not only are those who are Lent of the Lord, those who are least among us. But here's the last thing, those who are willing to be led by him. Verse 35 says, and they brought it, that is the donkey, to Jesus. Now, when you've been loaned and you're the least, the donkey, who is inexperienced, is tied to a rope. And someone, y'all, is carrying that donkey or leading that donkey. Bird, you know what it was when you first got those donkeys in the yard. You had to bring them to where they needed to be. They didn't know what it was. They didn't know what it is. It's brand new to them. So you have to lead them. Watch this. And God will use you if you let him lead you. It's the jack of the donkeys that's harder because they don't want to be led. Okay. I'm trying my best, sweetheart. I'm trying my best. What makes it hard for some of us is that we want him to be our savior, and we say he's our Lord, but he can't lead us nowhere. So the donkey watches. When God leads us, we go wherever God sends us. When the donkey is untied from the post, the donkey is just in the hands of those that leads. And those that lead are those that Jesus has sent. So whom has Jesus sent? The Holy Spirit. Watch this. When you've given yourself to the service of the master then gives you the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit leads you where you should go. And that time when you, as a jackass, trying to go somewhere else, and the Spirit say, trying to pull you, and you fighting with the Spirit. Now, there's going to come a point where the Spirit got to let you bump your head and hit your rock and break your foot, but he's going to get you back. He leads me. Watch this. Not only does allow him to take me where he want me to go, but then I stay connected to the master. I don't bite the rope that's leading me. Because, you know, goats and donkeys, they chew on anything. They'll chew on that thing. And they say, no, where you going to lead me? Watch this. And this is what I love about this. When they got there, the donkey was brought over to Jesus, was led to Jesus. And here's the deal. Check this out. They threw their coats on the donkey. And then they set the master on the donkey. When you're truly led of the Lord, you don't shake off what he done threw on you. Remember, he's inexperienced. He's young. He never been sat on. And there's some things God put on you you ain't never had before. But that's all right. Because somebody said he won't give you more. And somebody said, Lord, why are you putting this on me? Because you can handle it. Well, no, you know I'm weak. No. You say you weak. But when you are weak, I'm strong. And you got to understand, when the master is riding on your back. Watch this, y'all. Check this out. So here's what happened. So either one or three things was happening. Either Jesus was navigating the donkey, which was unlikely, because he was just riding like in a parade. Or the mother was tied to the donkey, because how you would work it out is you bring the experienced one, the mother, to right side, so she can kind of give some signals and donkey talk to the donkey. You okay, son? We okay? Just keep on going. Or, and it could be all three of them, two of them, somebody was leading. It doesn't matter which way. If God connect you with somebody who's been experienced to help you stay on the narrow, or if God going to lead you in the path of righteousness for his name's sake, whatever way it is, you got to let the Lord lead you to watch this, to what's going. But I like this, and then I'm going on home. Watch this. He was the hook for me. When they got into the city, the crowd started to shout, but the donkey ain't got bothered. Because you see, when folks are inexperienced, an inexperienced donkey would have thought the crowd would scare them. That's why you got to be led by somebody. The donkey does not get out of order because he knows if the parade is not for him. It's for the one that's on it. You don't need fanfare. You don't need attaboys and praise on the back if you really come here to serve the Lord. If you can't sing and preach and teach and serve unless somebody give you an attaboy and praise, stay your tail at home because you acting like a jackass. But what God needs is for somebody just to come up in here and say, I surrender all. Don't worry about who looking at you. You just do what God called you to do. Don't worry about if you get the donkey did not get the fanfare. The name of the movie is not Trek and the Donkey. The name of the movie is Trek, but the donkey still get paid. There's a no town, no county having parades, and they wanted all the queens from the different towns of the county to come and display for the county parade. And everybody was responsible to get their own vehicle to ride in. And the queen of one town had somebody with a convertible, and it was real nice. And another queen of the town had someone, and it was riding around town. And somebody, and as they was coming in, the folks at the podium was announcing Queen so-and-so, and all that kind of stuff. And it was going along, and somebody got back home, and parents got back home and asked their kids, how you like the parade? We talk about the queen. Says, well, I only saw but one queen. They said, one? They said, no, they had four of them. They said, no, I only saw one. They said, what you mean? They said, well, I saw the first one. The car that the queen was on had spinners on the wheels, had flashing lights on the grill. The music was thumping. And so I didn't know that was a queen. Because all I saw in the second one was rolling on some 22s. And they were thumping some other kind of music. And the man that was driving the car, he was waving like that. I didn't see the queen. But I did see that one. It was an old looking car. But it was clean. It was buffed up. It ain't had no spinners. There wasn't no light on the grill. Matter of fact, I didn't even think nobody was driving it. It wasn't a convertible, but they put the queen on the roof of the car. And so I could see the queen before I could see the car. Can I help somebody? The Bible says, if I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto me. Where do you have the King of Kings? Or you have him low down in your thumping car on some spinners? Or you rolling around with some 22s, waving everybody like it's your parade? Or do you have that old Buick Deuce in the quarter that's clean and looking good, but you got the king sitting on top of the roof, and let the King of Kings wave his hand, and you low down like this because you don't want to be seen, because it's not about you. It's all about can the Lord use you? This Palm Sunday, can the Lord use you? If he can use you, say, Lord, I may not be much to nobody else, but you make me what I am. Lord, I'm yielding myself to you. Lord, take my little money, ain't much, but all that I have, I surrender. And Lord, I don't want to be seen, but I want to put you on the roof so everybody else can see just who you are. Y'all, let the Lord use you. But be humble when he uses you. The donkey, when he did his job, went back to the owner, and Jesus went to Calvary. But the donkey did what he had to do. All you got to do is bring the master to the crowd. And once you've done your job, let him dismount and do his job. Because he's worthy to be praised. Pray with me if you would. Father, we thank you so much for your goodness, your grace. your abundance of mercy. God, how we honor you today and give you praise and thanks because you are a great and a mighty God. And God, we surrender all to you. All to you we owe. God, we live for you. So bless this time, minister this time, touch our hearts, even right now, God. God, how we love you, how we glorify you. God, with every head bowed, every eye closed, those who are among us, oh God, may they come to know you. If they are here, may they come to know you. May they give themselves to you. So, Lord, we just surrender ourselves to you this very day. Minister, God, in a mighty way. There may be someone here in our midst today. You, sir, you, ma'am, and you do not have a personal relationship with the Lord. You may have come to church. You may have been brought up in church, but never allowed him to be the Lord of your life. If you're here with us today, you want him to be the Lord of your life and the Savior of your soul. Would you come and join us and make that declaration? And you say unto the Lord, to Jesus, I accept your free gift. If you're here with us today, you want to give yourself to the Lord. Here's what it means. If you were to die today, do you have an absolute assurance beyond a shadow of a doubt that you will be with the Lord in eternity? If the answer to that question is, I don't know, Reverend, or no, then let me invite you to come and give yourself to the Lord. This is a mighty good day to do it. Because here's the deal. When we pass away, when we die, and we will one day, we got two locations that happens. We're either going to be with those who await God's coming and go to heaven, or those who await God's return and go to hell. You can't switch over and change your mind after it gets there, because there's no. And no one can barter or pray you over. It's just a matter of you having that, accepting that now. So if you want to accept Jesus Christ right now, we invite you to come. If you're looking for a church home, we invite you to come and be a part of the Minnehula Church. Now here at the Minnehula Church, we exist to love God, love people, and impact the world and the community in which we live. If you are among us today, you want looking for a church home, we invite you to come and be a part of the Minnehula Church. All to Jesus. I surrender me, Savior, holy God, we honor you, we praise you, we thank you for this day. And we pray and ask that your Holy Spirit would lead, guide, and direct each and every one that's under the sound of our voice. May we truly surrender all to you and give you everything we've got. So bless, minister, even touch right now. We ask it now in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. All to be my all to him. Amen, amen, amen. We surrender all. To God be the glory for all the marvelous things he has done. Listen, real quickly, get your offering out and prepare to give your offering. And as we prepare to leave, or as we're leaving, we're going to invite you to
put your offering in the plate as we're exiting out the door. So get your offering together. Let me make a couple of announcements just to highlight some things. First of all, next Sunday is Easter Resurrection Sunday. Regular service times, 11 a.m. Amen, amen. You'll be back in time for all those eggs that y'all gotta eat. Amen. And also, the students will have an Easter egg hunt immediately following our morning worship. And so, parents, make sure your students are here to participate in the Easter egg hunt. Also, on April the 6th, you've heard me announce them before, Texas Baptist, the particular office that I serve and work at, we are having we're putting on a big ministry and small town summit. It's going to be held at St. Peter's Minnehula. I need your support. I need at least 10 to 15 of us minimum to come and support. Amen. It's $10. It's not a whole lot. That's just going to cover our lunch. But we want to go and support. We always say that we are a resource to the region. And so God has placed Minnehula here. When I got here 16 years ago, Minnehula was provided and doing conferences and equipping workshops, and God has allowed us to continue to do that. And so come, because it's all about how do we do ministry in a big way, although we may be in a small town. Do you realize that you don't have to be in a big city to do big things? Hello, somebody. Minnehula is doing some big things, and although we are small folks, that's how y'all do all that. We walk by faith and not by sight. So we do what we do. So I need us to sign up, please. There's a website that's something that you can go to. If you just want to register, connect with Sister Flo or someone, and you can help us just get names. We want to get you registered. It's just $10. Now, how much is it? It's your $10, not our $10. Your $10. Amen. Amen. All it is, that's just number one at Whataburger. I'm just saying, get the Lord your number one. Since you say you want to surrender all, go ahead and give them $10. So we invite you to come and do that. Also, listen, we're getting ready for Vacation Bible School. It begins the Monday after Father's Day, the 17th is for 4 days. Now, we need to order VBS shirts and get those done. And so we need you to get with Sister Bird. If y'all have her number, text her. I'm sorry, get with Sister Sheila. Text her your shirt size. How many of you served last year in VBS? Let me see. Did you do anything in VBS? Anybody? You see the hand, Sheila? Okay, so you got their shirt size already? Raise your hands again if you did VBS last year. Who's gonna volunteer? Anybody want to add to the list? Deacon, I didn't see you raise your hand yet. Okay. We need to get by Friday. So listen, that's Good Friday. That'd be a good day. Good Friday would be a good day to get your shirt size to Sheila. So we can get them ordered. And so for those of you who are following us virtually, if you weren't here, just want you to know we got a t-shirt for you. If we get a t-shirt for you, that means you're gonna be working. Amen? Because you wasn't here to say that you wasn't gonna work. Yes, amen. And so we invite you to do that so we can get all things. It's an exciting time. We want to get all this stuff ready to go. Again, it's a four-day vacation Bible school. And I love our, I guess, not just the curriculum, but the schedule that we've had for the last 2 years. It worked out very well. It did some great things. And so we invite you to do that. Women, immediately after worship, for our women's ministry meeting in the fellowship hall, they got some good videos, I know, because I was there when they were being prepared. I'm telling you, it's going to be good. Now, men, go to Whataburger. No. if you stay, you're going to work. No. But the men did have a good time yesterday for their men's gathering breakfast. And so, brothers, I encourage all of our men of Minnehula to be a part. We had like 16 men gathered. We prayed for our community. We prayed for one another. We prayed for our churches. I need us to see more of us here. Great outpouring of the community. Fantastic. But we could double that if we just all showed up. Amen.
And then, and then, boy, we had deer sausage, pork sausage. Them eggs was good. Grits. Word on the street, them grits was good. We had biscuits. Ooh, Lord. Anyway, so y'all come out. Now our next men's gathering is gonna be in May. And so we invite you to come. All right. I got some prayer requests that I want to lift up, and then we're gonna ask prayer requests around the room. Let's be prayerful for Sister Candace Williams. She had to have an emergency surgery yesterday. And so there's some things going on, some fluid building up. And so the doctors, and I told her that she's in the best place to me in the world to get it done. So they caught it, they got it, and they was able to control it. Since she was in some pain, or she's in some pain, because where the surgery occurred. However, she's still in good courage. And so we're gonna continue praying for Sister Candace Williams in her recovery. Also, let's be praying for Brother Lane Killen. Lane had, he was on base, and it was having some activities, and he fell, and he had two fractures in his spine. And so, and it's one of his kidneys is having some issues. And so we're asking prayer. Lisa was able to get there to by his side. And so let's continue to pray for him. It's a good hospital, but it's a busy hospital where they are. And so y'all know our sister Lisa. Y'all pray for Lisa. Lisa, you watching. We praying for Lisa and for Lane. But let's pray for them. Also, there's some friends of ours. I'm going to ask us to pray for them. One by the name of Karen Lewis and the other Rodney House. They are in critical condition with illnesses. And so they are friends of mine. So I'm asking, they ask me to ask Minnie Hula to pray for them. Amen? Amen. Any other prayer requests? Praise reports. Prayer requests. Praise reports. We heard about Ryan's job interviews. Amen. So we're asking God to open those doors and he walk in them. Amen. But anything else you want to add? Let's pray for Peggy Cortinez. Dialysis. Bird. Mm-hmm. That's God. That's a word. And part two of the sermon is no, you're right. No, I appreciate it. Thank you for sharing that. I love when you can make application to it. That's what it's all about. Is this kid? Amen. She got, yeah. I told you, everybody start saving. But Bria did good too. y'all better start saving them coins to go to the Olympics. That's all I'm saying. Thank you, kid. We sure will. Did I see somebody's hands on this side? Pat? Let's pray for the Collins family. Amen. How old is Maya? How old is 8? I know she's 1 year after Ryan. Amen. Amen. 8 going on 18. Amen. Any others? Yeah. Y'all be prayerful for me. I'm in revival this week, first 3 days of the week in Spring, Texas at the True Vine Church. So we be prayerful for me on that. Let me thank and acknowledge, may not be a very first time guest, but a returning guest with us, Brother Steptoe and his family. Thank you so much. When he told me his name, I said, now what part of Louisiana are your family from? Because Steptoe is not a Texas name. He said that there's some Navasota or something? Okay, they just stopped in Navasota. They came from Louisiana. I'm just telling you. I bet you when we talk after, is your family, everybody from Port Arthur, Beaumont, Navasota, all that, Jasper,
all their family from Louisiana. They was on their way to Houston. They got tired and they stopped. I'm telling y'all how that worked. Some of my kin folks stopped them. They stopped in Port Arthur. I got a cousin because she was driving. She kept riding. She stopped in Houston. I got them step toes. I know they from Lafayette. I can tell you right now where they're from. Go find your people. I can call a couple of them on the phone and say, I met your cousin. Amen, amen, amen. I remember like when we first met Virginia, and she said, LeBlanc, I said, oh, so where your family from? Louisiana, she says, New Iberia. I said, yep, I know them. I grew up two doors down from Jen's family. Literally, I grew up at 813, and the LeBlancs were on the 900 block, which was a block and a half, a block. So I know all her people. I know all of them. I know the African-American side and the Anglo side. Because there's two sets of LeBlancs out there. Amen. Amen. Any other prayer requests? Yeah, yep. Pastor gonna find you. Look, you ain't got to call Gates. I can find where your people at. Everybody gonna get Louis Gates. I can tell you where your people at. Any other prayer request? Oh, Sister Irene asked that we pray for her, for her brother Alfredo, and also just asking prayers for herself. She's asking God to bless her with patience and understanding. Amen. All right, let's stand. God, our Father, how we thank you and praise you and give you glory and honor for all things. We acknowledge you as holy and mighty. God, we ask that as we prepare to receive offerings in a few minutes, that those offerings would be pleasing unto you, that we would be faithful and we would commit to giving a portion back to you that you blessed us with. God, we want to be good stewards of that which we retain, oh God, and we want to trust you and be faithful in giving our tithe and our offering. And so I pray, oh God, that every heart that's looking and doing their giving, may they do it remembering what you require and then look at what you respond and how you respond. So we give you praise and thanks for that. We ask and pray that you would be with Sheila's friends, oh God, who are going through some trying times right now, and that you would minister unto them, that you would guide them and provide everything that they have need of. Thank you, oh God, for opening doors for Ryan, and I pray that you would continue to have him and lead and guide him as he walks therein. Thank you for the healing that you provided in his body and in his being. God, thank you for Bria's accomplishments on the track field, God, and thank you, God, for at least in my presence, just for her humility. Now, God, use her in a great way, God. Not just to be a runner on the track field, but to be a runner of the word, oh God, and that wherever she goes, she can display, Heavenly Father, your godliness in her, or godliness through her lives. God, we lift up the Collins family and pray your blessings upon them. Minister unto them, God, as only you can. God, we lift up Karen and Rodney and pray your blessings upon them. Ask that you would heal and touch. Give the doctors what they need to provide care and attention to them. God, we lift up Candace and Lane before you, God. They are in critical issues and stakes right now. And so we just entrust them into your hands. Thank you, God, for doctors that's going to come in and continue to do a good work. We pray, oh God, for those of us who are waiting to see what you're going to do and how you're going to do it. We know that you can do all things but fail. So we give you praise and thanks for that. Be with Brother Alfredo and bring healing and comfort in his body, restoration and wholeness, oh God. And then, God, we do ask and pray in Jesus' name that you be with Sister Irene as she's asking for your strength and her own self, for patience and for understanding. So minister as only you can. God, how we love you and praise you and thank you for it, even right now. And we ask it all in Jesus' name. We walk by faith and not by sight. I walk by faith and not by sight. Now may the grace of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with each and every one of us as we leave this place, but never his presence. In Jesus' name, amen. Go in the blessings of God.